dietitian Ritika Lamba. I am a well-qualified clinical dietitian with a degree of Master in Nutrition and Dietetics. And today I am going to talk to you about how to disinfect your fruits and vegetables and the groceries that are delivered to our house literally. As this thing came into my mind, as I saw yesterday's news of a pizza guy, as he was suffering from COVID-19, as he was infected by this virus, as so many people might have been infected because of the delivery from him. So I thought of telling you how we can prevent it. The best thing is if we can set up a station like this in our house near to our gate. Actually near to gate by, because as soon as these deliveries are delivered to us, we can control it, we can disinfect them. So my workstation, as you can see, consists of a bottle of Dettol and then sanitizer. Then I've kept some soda and salt mixed together in this. And but first thing what I'm going to do is clean up my work surface where I'm going to work. Clean the area very nicely where you are going to put all your home delivered items. One by one, take out the things from you. See, I have bought almost all the things which I think most of the people will be using, from tin to plastic to cardboard to plastic bottles, to the packets of besan, suji, and then the chanas, cream, and lastly the jeera also. So I ordered all these things to show you how we can effectively disinfect them. See, the plastic, the virus stays in the plastic for 72 hours. So what we can do is, as soon as we order a bottle of Sprite, Coke, Fanta, anything, what we can do is take the Dettol soap, put it like this effectively, and put it in the bucket of water. Similarly, the mayonnaise also, the plastic. And then we see there's a tin. It stays, the virus stays longer on the tin. So I'm dipping it in the water. And after some time, I'll take them out, clean them with a cloth, and put it in my kitchen. The next is a fresh cream. This contains, this is made up of cardboard, even Nutrela, made up of cardboard. The virus stays here for 24 hours. If you don't need it immediately, then you can put it like that also outside, let it stay without touching for 24 hours. Otherwise, if you need them, then same way you can put the detergent, soap, liquid, anything, and then you can put it in the bucket of water. And this thing, you can cut it. You can open this pack, you can cut it, and you can pour all the contents into a container. Otherwise, you can simply wipe it off also with the sanitizer and the wipes, using the wipes. And then you can place it. The packets of suji and besan, everything can be cleaned, you know, with the detergent. So later on, take out the things. And nowadays, as people are cooking so much, they are using a lot of cheese also. So the best way to deal with cheese is, open it up, take out the cubes, put them into something without touching them directly, and throw the outside cover. That's the best way to handle your these kind of perishable items which cannot be kept out for 72 hours. And similarly, the paste also, take it out in your toilet like this and throw the outer cover off this. Similarly with the jeera packet, similarly with the chana packet, similarly with the besan packet. So here is what I am telling you how to deal with your groceries. And the second thing I'm going to tell you is how to deal with your fresh fruits and vegetables. It is very simple. You know, you should not wash your fruits and vegetables with detergents, soaps and sanitizers. The easiest way to do them is take a bucket of water, full of water, and then you add some salt and meter soda mixed into it. And pour all your fruits and vegetables into them without touching. This way. See, here I have capsicum, and I have tomatoes, then I've got some oranges, then the tomatoes. Skin is very porous. If we put all these detergent and sanitizers, then it will penetrate into them. And then they're going to be toxic for our digestive system. they can cause, by too much of ingestion, they can cause diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, and we need to prevent all those other symptoms. So I'm going to keep it for 30 minutes aside. Then again, I'm going to clean and wipe off my work surface. Close the lid, clean your work surface clean, wipe off everything from here. See, basically after handling all these things, the main important part is not to touch your nose or your mouth. Why? Because this virus transfers into our body through our nose and mouth only. The best part is to prevent it is immediately after handling these stuff, wash your hands with soap and liquid soap and water for 20 seconds. You need to wash it very carefully, all the sides, insides, your nails, everything for 20 seconds, keep rubbing them. And then put them in the running water. After 30 minutes, when my vegetables are, I'm done with my vegetables, I'll be taking out my vegetables, putting them into the basket, and then I'm going to take them to my kitchen, put them under running water for 20 seconds more, and then I'm going to keep them out for drying, and then I'll store them in my refrigerator. This is all about how to disinfect our groceries and vegetables, supplies which we get from outside. Two more points which I would like to say here are basic. We step out of the house, maybe to go to the bank, maybe to give money to someone, or maybe anything. We are just standing outside our gate and we don't know if somebody has spitted outside our gate. So the best precaution what we can take is, you know, that virus can contaminate our shoes. Wearing those shoes coming inside the house, we are bringing virus directly into our house. Best way is to keep two pairs of shoes, one for going out and one for wearing inside the house. Then I'm going to talk about another point with you, not taking much of your time, but I would really like to suggest you that sometimes, you know what happens, people wear masks in a very wrong manner. I have seen people wearing masks half covering their half. This is the exact way of wearing a mask. Normally people wear masks like this also, I have seen. You know, the virus can infect your nose. So it can go inside your body through your nose also. So this is not the way. You need to cover exactly. Either you can buy such disposable mask, or you can buy some, you can make also, you can buy some also this kind of washable cotton mask according to the size. And you know, then you can wear it to cover your entire nose and mouth and avoid touching your nose and mouth as much as you can. Keep washing your hands, don't touch your mouth and nose, and try to stay indoors. You know, the best way to prevent this virus, the COVID-19, is by not going outside your house. Do this and all the best.